In this video, I'll show you how to create a reader account and then share some data with it. Maybe you have a client or somebody else that you want to actually access your data, but they themselves don't have a Snowflake account. What Snowflake offers is what's called a reader account that will give them their own interface, their own account number, everything that looks pretty similar to this, and a place for them to log in. The only difference is all of their activity will be billed back to you. But how would you set that up? First, you have to be on an account admin role, so you have to have permission for that. Go to Account, Reader Accounts, Create. This is the name of the account. As it says here, this is not the name of, this is not the account number. This is more like the alias that you want to call it. So let's just call this Test Reader. Comments, a Test Reader account for the demo. Admin login information. This will be the default user that logs in as the account admin on the reader account. So whenever you make this, you can hand this off, give that to them, and they can go in and start creating other users and other resources. So I will call this test password . Okay, congratulations. Just like that, we've created a reader account locator, and it's going to give us a URL. So once we have this URL, we can log into the account and see what it looks like. It will look very similar to what we have here. And this is something that you can share and send to your clients or whoever it is that you want this reader account to be made for. So here it is. Here's the locator, here's their account number, and here's the links. So you may get an error the first few times as it loads this up, but once you click on this here, it'll take you to a login screen. I'll put in the user and password that I just made for the reader account. And here we are, we're logged in. Let's just dismiss this for now. And as you can see here, this is the basic setup. Test is an admin. It has account admin permissions. No warehouses here, there's no databases, because it's all from scratch. It's as if it's a brand new account, because it is. It's just rolling up under your account. Now let's say we want to share some data with them. Right now there's nothing here. Let's say we want to share something with them. So we can go to share, outbound. Let's create a new one. So we're going to share data from this account to this one. Let's create a new one. Create, give a name for the share, demo. Share database. This falls under demo DB. And here it is. Here's that table. Again, it says no secured views. We had other views in there, but they're not secured. That's why it doesn't show up. So we'll do this team details, apply, and create. Okay, so it was created successfully and it's there. Okay. Now, next, add consumers. Type full or reader. In this case, we're going to do reader because we want to give it to this reader account that we just made here. So drop down, sees it's here, add. Okay, as it says here, log in as an account admin and create from share so you guys can see it. I'm going to go back here and as account admin here, I'll go to shares. And if I go to inbound, I can now see this here. Here it is. This is shared by this account, which is this one here. So if we're hopping back and forth, this shows that it was shared by our other account and it was just created. This is my local time. It was shared by our, that other main account. So now if we click on this and say create database from share, we can give it a custom name. So the name of the share is this, but let's say I want to give it a different name locally. I'll call it local DB, give just the name of the database, give access to, we'll do sysadmin and account admin, create. Okay. Now let's go to the worksheet, refresh, and here it is. And we can see this here now. Now we don't have a warehouse set up here, so we can't preview and we can't select from it, but once we have that set up, we will be able to. So now as you continue over in this account and, you know, maybe you make some more tables or views, you want to add them to the share, you know, you add them here. As you do that, here I have another one here. Let's just, for the sake of example, add this guy. Edit. Okay. If we go back here and refresh, now we see both of them. It's very easy to share data between users and even users who may just have a reader account. I hope you found this helpful. Please let me know if you have any other questions, and I will see you at the next video.